I think so. I think I was incredibly
naive. Or innocent,
naive.
Innocent, really.
Yes, yeah. An innocence, a naivety.
Right.
So I got the money to go and see Louis Armstrong, and I met Dil Jones there. And I said, why was it so special for me to come and see this bloke before it started?
Yeah.
You know, because I wasn't used to jazz at that time. Yeah, yeah. I was used to chapel, you know, the Messiah and all right. of that.
Yeah, yeah.
And he just shut me up with this kiss. He just pulled me to him. Well, when Louis Armstrong kisses you with that mouth, it's not just the mouth. It's like the nose and the chin as well, you know, like making a meal of the lower half of the face. It's very enthralling. I've never been kissed before like that, ever. I didn't know such kisses existed.
How many people were in the room at that stage?
Oh, it was a mélange of people backstage, you know what I mean, as it were.
Almost like
but
a party atmosphere.
Drinking and everything frightened me.
Yeah.
And
did you drink very much at that stage?
No, I hadn't hit the bottle then.
Right.
And I hated drink because I hated what it had done to my parents. That was so embarrassing and horrible. I was the only student in Brighton who didn't drink. Because I was a scholarship girl,
yes.
I was very aware of that. They came from a different background to me, in any case. And I only was interested in being in the art school and doing the work. You know what I mean?
Mm.
And anyway, so... he so changed me because he set my blood boiling. That and the music set my blood boiling. It gave me a new high, which I hadn't experienced before.
Yes, stars shining bright above you. Night breezes sing to whisper I love you. Birds singing.
Do you have a lot of regrets in your life?
No, I don't have regrets. Only that one about the being the mother, alcoholic mother. And regretting, I thought, you know, quite, you know, would have, now I think about it, Louis Armstrong would have been a wonderful one to give my virginity to. I'm a bit sorry I said no now, but, you know, James Robson was the one for me. And, I wish that I had gone with Cary Grant. That is a bit of a regret. Mm. And that I'd continued dancing with Sean Connery.
Why did you turn him down?
Well, because my husband came back from the lavatory.
Right.
And Omar Sharif, my husband, came back from the lavatory. That I do regret. But, you know, they were my husbands. They were men that I loved, you know. And our sex life was, married sex for me was wonderful.
Can I just thank you once again? And anybody that hasn't actually seen this book or read this book, welcome to Mollywood. It's available now. Go and get it. It's an absolute scream. Molly Parkin, thank you very much.
Thank you.